YouTube down to Bricks here, and have I got a treat for you today. Two beautiful Lego models. I really wanted to bring you this face-off video just to highlight how fantastic both of these models are. And maybe you're in the position where you've got the new one and you've always wondered how it stacks up to the old one, or maybe you don't have either of these models and you just want to check out two awesome UCS sets, or you could have the old model and you've been asking yourself, should I be buying the new Y-Wing? So we're going to have a chat about all of that at the end of the video. But first of all, I think last video that I did with the face-off between the playable versions of the X-Wing, that I'll take that same approach and just do some side-by-side comparisons. Now, that's not going to be easy with two models of this size. We'll also run through some of the play features. Now, being a traditional UCS set, there's not a lot of play features, especially on the old one, but we do have several features that I will show for the new model. And we also have a few minifigs to take a look at too. So what are the two models we have in front of us? Well, on the left hand side, we have set 75181. It's the Y-Wing Starfighter UCS set from 2018, has 1,967 pieces and comes with two minifigs. On the right hand side, we have set 10134, the Y-Wing Attack Starfighter UCS set from 2004, has 1,473 pieces and comes with one minifig. So it's a long time between sets at 14 years. So let's go in and see how LEGO have changed it up. So starting with the front of the Y-Wings, now I've always really just liked the shape that they achieved with the 2004 model. Now there are some stickers used between both models, although there are a lot more used on the new 2018 model. On the old model here, we have two stickers on the side here, and the cockpit is actually decorated with stickers. On the new model, this top section is actually printed on the cockpit, but on the side that is a sticker. We also have a sticker here, 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 and two on the front, and of course on the other side as well. It's interesting to note that the same cockpit canopy piece is actually the same piece between the models. And I do think the sticker here is a better sticker combination to actually separate the two sections of the canopy compared to this new sticker. Both models have rotating ion cannons, and both models have some nice detail under the canopy. We have a targeting computer on the 2018 model and a nice control yoke. And we have a similar setup on the old 2004 model, and I think they're both very good builds. You can also fit a minifig inside the new model, and you can take the targeting system out of the way to get your minifig inside. And just to show, you can put a minifig in the old model as well, although it doesn't come with a pilot. Also note that the new one is decorated with stickers. One of the big differences between the two models are the engines, and you can see they are a lot smaller on the new model. Looking at the sensor array dome at the front, I actually prefer the 2004 choice of using this single piece for the dome rather than these four quarter pieces. While the 2004 model has an incredible level of detailing, I think the 2018 model is an improvement, with the use of parts giving a more cylindrical effect to the engine build. Now this really does highlight the difference in the engine sizes here. And as you can see, detailing continues down the sides of both models, and it even continues underneath on the 2018 model. Looking from behind, I do like the thrusters in both models. Quite a difference in the rear vectors here between the two. And I do like the addition of the rear steering plates here in the 2018 model. And with the shorter support pylons in the 2018 model, I think will assist in any sagging issues into the future. Both models come with a stand with a plaque with the Starfighter statistics on it. On this older model, it does tend to sit back a little bit on the stand. And if we take it off, and as you can see, very sturdy to hold. And having a look at the undercarriage here, and you can see it's very plain. It's all just the bottom of plate, so nothing to really look at underneath this model. The stand for the 2018 model comes with mounting blocks for your minifigures, and you also have an adjustable position for display purposes. And as with both models, you have different directional options to display on the stand as well. Looking at the undercarriage of the 2018 model, and before we look at that again, very sturdy to hold, and the detailing here is very impressive. Right from the very front here, we have no real studs showing there. It's all nice and smooth underneath. We have nice shape to it and just some very nice detail, more bars underneath, and we also have landing gear here as well, so we can fold these skids down. We have these on both engines here, and really just great detail underneath the model. And of course you can just display it off the stand like so if you wish. So I think the last thing to look at now is the fuselage, but I'll just start from the back of the ship here, and the best way for me to do this is just to go over both models. So we'll start with the 2004, having a look at the detail as we go. And I remember building this model and just being thoroughly impressed with the level of detail. And we do have some printed pieces here. That is a printed piece, but just tons of greebling. And of course we do get a position for our astromech droid. We do have some more printed slopes here with a little bit of damage, battle damage on them. Very nice pieces those are. And really just impeccable, the level of detail. But if we think that is great, check this out now. The 2018 model is just taken to an all new level. Just such a great selection of parts. Certainly assisted by the selection of new parts. But just have a look along here, the depth that they've managed to achieve with the use of greebling. I mean, have a look at that. There's just really no studs at all. It's just greebling, different layers of greebling. It's quite incredible. And there is our position for our astromech droid. And we do have a shaft down in there. I mean, just look down in there. Isn't that incredible? Now, this is one of the features, so you can turn this shaft and rotate the ion cannon on top. So, works very nice and smooth as well. So, nice little feature there. But it really is just amazing. And I've got to say, through the build process of this model, it just seemed to go together so easily. So I definitely recommend this model for a range of ages. I think it's for 16 and up, but definitely builders younger than that, advanced builders younger than that, could definitely take on this model with no problem at all. So some of the highlights with the Greebling for me, the use of this round tile with the hole on a shield piece, vertical binocular pieces there, a skate piece, whip piece used for tubing there, all the different bars used, very impressive. A bit of track in light bluish grey there as well. All in all, just amazing. And now just a quick look at the minifigs. On the left are our two new minifigs from the 2018 model. We have, I believe, its exclusive Astromech droid, R2BHD, and of course the Rebel pilot Dutch Vander himself, Gold Leader. This minifig has some awesome torso and leg printing, a very nice helmet piece and printing. And last of all is our 2004 Astromech droid, and it's listed on Bricklink as R5D4, although I always thought R5D4 was the droid from the homestead scene on Tatooine, and actually had the more cone-shaped headpiece, more like this droid here than the dome piece, but I could be wrong about that. A look from behind, and the alternate face print for Dutch Vander. So now that we have gone over both of these models, and it was a bit of a mission going over both of these big models for this comparison, but now it's time to have a chat about what I think LEGO have done well with the new model and which model I do prefer. So straight off the bat, I'm gonna say that I definitely think the 2018 model is the better model. Now, I'm not going to say it's a clear standout from the 2004. Obviously, with the choice of new parts and the chance for the designers to revisit the old model and make some improvements has definitely helped the 2018 model. So some of the big difference is the use of colors, especially along the engines. Without studying any images or drawings, I think the new model is proportioned a little bit better. The underside of the 2018 model is a vast improvement over the 2004 model, and just the level of Greebling and detail on the 2018 model is something to behold. Now, with saying all that, I still love this 2004 model. I just think both of these sitting together like this look absolutely fantastic. And I think those color differences actually help both models if you want to display them in your collection. It certainly gives a point of difference. And if you were to think that it was 14 years later, the 2018 model to the 2004, I really think it highlights how good that 2004 model really is. So all in all, while I do think the 2018 model is the better Y-Wing of the two, I've got to say I am really stoked to have both of these in my collection. And I think they're going to look pretty stellar up with all the other UCS sets. It's probably about time I do another UCS collection video and show off some of these models. But I think that covers it for this Ultimate Collector Series face-off. Let me know in the comments your thoughts. I'd love to hear from you. Let me know which one you like better. What is it about these two models that you really love? I'd love to hear from you. Let me know also what have you got in your collection, and are you looking to pick up either of these models? Now, I did pick up the 2018 model from Big W. I did reach out to Big W because I know there has been some supply issues, like that the amount of stock sold out very quickly. I have reached out to Big W, and there are a few stores out there that still have some stock. So if you're in Australia and you're wanting to pick up that set, reach out to your local Big W and see if they can help you source one of these models for you. So I think that will do us for today, folks. So please give the video a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button if you want to see more, because I have stacks more on the way. A big thank you for taking the time to watch, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.